Hi, and welcome to SIM Local. We're going to show you how to install your travel eSIM on your phone using a QR code. Before you begin, make sure your phone is unlocked from a carrier and that you have a stable internet connection. There are three ways to scan a QR code when installing your eSIM. The first two methods will need a second device to display the QR code, like on a laptop, desktop, or another smartphone. Option 1. Install using the camera app. First, on the iPhone that you want to install the eSIM, open the camera app. Point your camera at the QR code that was sent to your inbox when you purchased the plan. If you purchased it through the eSIM Local app, you'll find the QR code there too. A yellow prompt will pop up on the screen. Tap it and follow the instructions to complete the installation. Option 2. Install via settings. Open the settings on your iPhone and select Mobile Service or Cellular. Now tap Add eSIM and select Use QR Code. You'll be able to scan the QR code that you've received. Option 3. Scan a screenshot or image. If your iPhone is running iOS 17 or newer, you can install an eSIM directly from a screenshot or image of the QR code. For iOS 17.4 and later, locate your QR code on your phone. Next, tap and hold the QR code, then select Add eSIM from the pop-up menu and follow the instructions to complete the installation. For other iOS 17 versions, go to Settings and navigate to Mobile Service or Cellular. Next, tap Add eSIM. Select Use QR Code, then choose Open Photos. Select the screenshot of your QR code in your camera roll. Now that you've scanned your QR code, follow these steps to install your eSIM. When you're asked to activate the new eSIM, tap Allow and then Continue. Your screen will then say Connecting to Network. This part can take a couple of minutes. Next, you may then be automatically prompted to select a label for your plan. Usually your home SIM is called Primary, and the eSIM profile is called Personal, Travel, or Secondary. But you can choose any custom name you prefer. We recommend calling it SIM Local, or naming it after the country you're planning to visit. If you're not automatically prompted to rename your eSIM profile, you can do it later. Go to Settings, Mobile Service, or Cellular Service. Under SIMs, tap your new eSIM. Select Mobile Plan Label and choose Custom Label. But next, you'll need to select your default voice line. If you want to continue using your home number to receive calls and texts, select your primary line. Otherwise, select your secondary or newly labeled plan. Once that's done, you'll be asked about your iMessage and FaceTime preferences. Make sure you select Primary to keep these on. Then, in your mobile data settings, make sure you select your secondary or newly labeled plan to allow data to be used on your eSIM. Finally, let's make sure that Allow Mobile Data Switching is turned off. Great, we're nearly done. Now all you have to do is turn on data roaming. Go to Settings, Mobile Service or Cellular, and under SIMs, tap on your new eSIM. At the bottom, toggle Data Roaming on. And that's it. You've successfully installed your new SIM Local eSIM like a pro.